السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن شاء الله الآية verse number 30 سورة النساء، verse number 30 سورة النساء. الله سبحانه وتعالى says: ومن يفعل ذلك عدوانا وظلما فسوف نصليه نارا وكان ذلك على الله يسيرا. And whoever does that in aggression and injustice. What is the previous ayah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the previous ayah, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ. Okay? Or you who have believed, don't consume one another's wealth unjustly. So this ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, number 30, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ. And whoever does that. So that means only ayah number 29, or it can include all the haram things, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many haram things, many I mean prohibited things in the previous ayat. So it can be both. It can mean the previous ayah dhalik, which is in the ayah number 29, or all the haram things mentioned in the previous ayat. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ عُدْوَانًا وَظُلْمًا. طيب، الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned two things: عُدْوَانًا وَظُلْمًا. And whoever does that in aggression and injustice. Both of them will be haram, because you know sometimes you do something as عُدْوَان, as aggression. But this is allowed. Why? As a reply. Allah subhanahu وتعالى says, وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها. وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها. What is the يعني allowed for you to have like a recompense for someone who made aggression for you to do the same towards him? This is عدوان. This is عدوان, aggression. But this is allowed. Why? Because this is as a reply. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المستبان ما قال فعلى البادئ منهما. What's mean مستبان? مستبان, the two people, persons who are insulting each other. Okay? ما قال فعلى البادئ منهما. Okay? Someone insulted me. He said bad word to me. And I replied. And he said another word. I replied the same. Okay? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فعلى البادئ. The sin will be only for the first person. Bad. What do you mean bad? The one who started. The one who started. Okay? So when he said this bad word to me, this is aggression. So he'll be a sinner. And when I say the same word to him, also this is aggression. But this is allowed. But here in the eye, what do you notice? عدوان وظلمة. Aggression and unjust. So when I reply, this is aggression, but just. This is just. Okay? You see, of course, we don't mean this is recommended. It's better to forgive. Okay? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ. يعني, when you punish, وَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِمِثْلِ. What does it mean, mithli? Exactly the same. The same. طيب؟ بمثل ما عوقبتم. But, ولي صبرتم. But if you are patient, this is better for those who are patient. So, don't understand from the ayah, it's better to, it is recommended to, يعني, reply the same. No, it's better to have patience. It's better to forgive. تمام؟ So, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned both things, عدوانا وظلما. And whoever does that in aggression and injustice, فسوف نصليه نارا, then we will drive him into a fire. نصليه. Okay, نصليه. The word نصليه, this is from صلي, to make something grilled. So it is like punishment in the hellfire. May Allah protect us. نصليه نارا. كان ذلك على الله يسيره. And that for Allah is always easy. It is not difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to punish people. It is very easy for him. In dunya, sometimes it is difficult, sometimes it is impossible to catch someone and to punish him. Okay, you know, nowadays in dunya, someone, you find, yani after stealing something, he will disappear. You cannot catch him. Or he will not disappear. He will go to another country and he will enjoy the money there. And you cannot touch him, صح? It is called لجوء سياسي. To stay there politically protected. Enjoying all the haram money he stole. And we can't see him and we watch him in the media. We cannot touch him. But dunya, sorry, in the akhirah, no one can escape the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. وما يفعل ذلك وما يفعل ذلك عدوانا وظلما فسوف نصليه نارا وكان ذلك على الله يسيرا. طيب. What we understand from this ayah, anyone who oppresses the others, he's oppressing the first thing, he's oppressing himself. Okay, when you beat, when you steal, when you oppress anyone, okay, this means you are oppressing yourself. Why? Because you bring the sin to yourself. You should remember that to protect yourself. And also from the eye, it is very, very important to know the danger of oppressing the others. Because you know the sins, like the reward. Okay? There is a sin for yourself only, and there is a sin for the others. I mean, if you escape, if you don't fast, no doubt this is haram, major sin. But this is related to yourself. But when you kill someone, there's someone else. And the same thing, the reward. When I pray, this is for myself, the prayer. No doubt, a lot of reward. But when you do something for others, you teach people knowledge, you give charity, reward. I mean, generally, the reward will be more if it is read to others. And also, we learn from this ayah that we should not rely on the patience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is not punishing us. Allah is al-Halim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Halim. One of the names of Allah, al-Halim. What does it mean, al-Halim? الَّذِي يُمْهِلْ وَلَا يُهْمِلْ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. He gives chance for people. Okay? And he doesn't punish immediately. Okay? Most of the time, he doesn't punish immediately. Allah gives people chance. Okay? So some people think that I am okay. Allah loves me. Okay? Allah is pleased with me. Why? Because he's not punishing him. I'm taking money from here and there, killing, doing this. And alhamdulillah, my health is strong, well, perfect, everything is perfect, my family, my job. He thinks that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish him. And this is wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُمْلِي لِلظَّالِمِ حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives chance for the one who's ظالم, oppressor. Okay? حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتْ. But when it comes, the time punishment, he cannot escape. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited, وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَى وَهِيَ ظَالِمَ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the villages, which means that they are oppressors, his punishment is severe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his torment is severe. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, next ayah 31 mentioned, إن تجتنبوا كبائر ما تنهون عنه نكفر عنكم سيئاتكم وندخلكم مدخلا كريما. 31. If you avoid the major sins which you are forbidden, we will remove from you your lesser sins and admit you to a noble entrance into paradise. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, after mentioning these sins, he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا, if you avoid, كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ. Okay, what does it mean, that كَبَائِر major? So we understand from this ayah, or it is very clear that the sins are not the same. There are major sins, minor sins. we should be careful. Doesn't mean that when we say major and minor sin, major sin, we should avoid minor sin. Okay. All of them are sins, haram. All of them are haram. Because, you know, some people ask, Sheikh, this is major or minor? What is the point to ask? What is the point? Okay. The point is, if it is minor, it's okay. I will do it and Allah ghafur rahim. And also the major, Allah is ghafur rahim. Allah is ghafur rahim only with the minor? Also with the major. The shaitan tells the person like that. If you tell the questioner saying, this is major or minor, you tell them minor. Okay, khalas. So it's okay to do it. Allah ghafur rahim. But also the shaitan will lead him to do the major sins, because also Allah is ghafur rahim. You find people not praying at all. When you tell them, you advise them, Allah ghafur rahim. No zakat, no salat, nothing. Allah ghafur rahim. This is the only thing he knows from Islam. Allah ghafur rahim. But you should know that there are many things that we have to do in Islam. Five pillars of Islam. And other compulsory things in Islam, they are not doing. Only they know Allah ghafur rahim. Right? No doubt, Allah is ghafur rahim, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shadeed. Iqab wal adab, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This term is very severe. So, in tajtanibu kaba'ira ma tunhawna anhu, when you avoid the major sins, nukaffir ankum sayyatikum. Okay, we'll forgive the sayyat. Here, sayyat means the minor. Right? And we have the hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned as-salawat wa khams wal-jum'ah ila al-jum'ah wa ramadan ila ramadan, the five prayers, and jum'ah from jum'ah to jum'ah, and from ramadan to ramadan. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mukaffirat. Okay, this will the sins will be forgiven in between. Okay, mukaffirat lima baynahun. But what is the condition? إذا اجتنبت الكبائر. If you avoid the major sins. Okay, this hadith, صحيح مسلم. الصلوات الخمس, five prayers, جمعة لجمعة, طيب, ورمضان إلى رمضان. مكفرات لما بينهن. إذا اجتنبت الكبائر. When you avoid the major sins. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تحترقون. إذا صليتم وظهر غسلتها. Okay. What does it mean, تحترقون? From the fire, you are burned because of your sins. But when you pray dhuhr, this will wash it, wash the sins. Then again, you burn yourself with sins. When you pray al-asr, al-asr will wash it. Then you burn yourself with the sins. Again, maghrib, al-isha. So, subhanAllah, these the five prayers will wash your sins. Also, al-umrah, when you do umrah to the next umrah, Ramadan, okay, al-Hajj will forgive all the sins, previous sins. طيب. And this narration, the Prophet mentioned, if you avoid the major sins. There is another narration without this part. And that's why, like Sheikh Al-Bai Rahmullah mentioned, Allah will forgive all the sins without this condition. Without this condition. And also, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen tends to have this opinion when he explained Sahih Bukhari that Allah will forgive all the sins according to this hadith without this condition. But we should not rely on that, because how can we make sure that Allah accepts our deeds? This is very important. Like when we tell you for your immunity, okay, to strengthen your immunity, okay, do exercise, healthy food, okay, take vitamin C, vitamin D, like honey, like Zamzam water, dates, like, طيب. Maybe some people say, خلاص, I take vitamin C and this is enough. Maybe it is not enough for you. You need to support this with other things, with the exercise, with the, okay, the same thing for getting the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't say, والله, خلاص, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you say subhanallah bihamdi 100 times, Allah will forgive your sins. Even it is like that. Filth or form of the sea. Khalas, I say subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, 100 times, and khalas, for sure Allah will forgive my sins. You don't know. You don't know. Of course, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. But we need to do more and more. You pray, you give charity, do umrah, hajj, and you say subhanAllah bihamdi 100 times. You do the things to get the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't rely on one thing. And this, of course, we don't mean that we should, we don't trust what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned or what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. The point is, we are not sure that Allah accepted all our deeds. As there's a saying, لو أعلم أن الله تقبل مني حسنة اتكلت. If I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted one hasana from me, then I will rely on that hasana. But I'm not sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted from me one hasana. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept only from those who are muttaqun. المتقين, the righteous, the pious people. So here the word kabira, what is the definition of kabira? What is the meaning or what is the definition of the major sin? Okay. There are sins that are clear. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned punishment. Like zina, wal-iyadu billah. Zina, adultery. What is the punishment? 100 lashes, not married. If he is married, stoning. Okay, to cut the hand for the thief, sifting. Like al-khamr, there are clear. So some scholars said, any sin, that there is a punishment for that. Okay, or telling that he will be in the hellfire. Or he will not enter paradise, or there is a curse, or there is an anger, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look at him, لا ينظر إليه subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Allah will not purify him, Allah will not accept from him, or he is not a believer. Okay, so like these things, this is a major sin. Okay? For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يدخل الجنة قاطع, the one who is قاطع رحم, who cuts his relations, he will not enter paradise. Okay, he will not enter paradise. So we understand this is major sin. Wallahi la yu'min. Wallahi la yu'min. Wallahi la yu'min. Alladhi la yu'min jaruhu wa wa'iquhu. He will not believe. He will not believe. Or he is not a believer. He is not a believer. Which means like perfect believer. That he is not safe from the... He does make his neighbor safe from his problems. So you understand that bothering the neighbor is major sin. So the scholars mention these things, and what is the famous book by Imam Dhahbi rahimahullah ta'ala, Kitab al-Kaba'ir, and also by Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab rahimahullah, there is a book called Al-Kaba'ir. The scholars wrote about Al-Kaba'ir. And there is saying by famous saying by Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala, when he was asked about Al-Kaba'ir, there are only seven, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it's 10 with seven. الموبقات, the seven destructive sins. So he was asked, they are only seven? He said, إلى السبعين أقرب. He said, no. To say they are 70, this is more authentic. So there are many major sins mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what do we learn from this ayah? سعد فضل الله سبحانه وتعالى. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the most merciful سبحانه وتعالى. That you don't do tawbah, you don't do repentance for these sins, but Allah will forgive your sins if you avoid the major sins. This is one of the things that tells you the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Imagine if there should be for every single sin you have to make tawbah, repentance. It will be difficult. But subhanAllah, if you avoid the major sins, Allah will forgive the minor sins. Not only that, if you do hasanat, Allah also will forgive the sayyat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. The good deeds will remove the bad deeds. So you'll find many things that you'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive our sins. This is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we learned from the ayah that All the Muslims will enter paradise. All the Muslims, as this is the belief of Ahlus Sunnah Jama'ah, all the Muslims will enter paradise. But some Muslims will be punished because of their sins. Because of their sins, they will be punished. And some of the Muslims, Allah will forgive their major sins. إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this two times. Allah will not forgive shirk. Shirk, khalas. Not be forgiven. But what is this last shirk? Okay. This can be forgiven if Allah wills. Not sure. Not sure. Okay, what does it mean, Shaykh? What does it mean with that? If Allah wills. That if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, He will forgive the shirk. Sorry, this last shirk. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to forgive, the person will be punished, then he will be in paradise. He will be in paradise. So the madhab of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that all the Muslims will be in paradise. No doubt. All the Muslims. And also, what we learn from this ayah, that for the major sins, there should be tawbah. There should be tawbah, repentance. Okay, for the major sins. Yani maybe the minor sins, even without thinking about them, Allah can forgive them. How? If you avoid the major sins, if you do hasanat. Or the disease. Diseases. Allah will forgive you the sins, the minor sins. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned about al-humma, fever. Hadith of Musa'ib, when the Prophet ﷺ visited one of the ladies, Umm Sa'ib. Okay? So he found this lady like suffering because of humma, fever. Ya Umm Sa'ib, malika tuzafzifin. Yani, like there is sound of suffering. Then she said, humma, la barakallah bil humma. Humma, fever. May Allah not bless humma. Prophet ﷺ said, not accept that. You are making dua against this disease. Why? Because تذهب بالذنوب it clears your sins like كما تذهب النار يعني like you know the one who's you know to make the iron huh? The smith huh? The blacksmith huh? Yes طيب how he is using the fire to make the diamond. This is the way of humma, the fever, to clean your sins. So I mean, sometimes your sins are forgiven because of what? Because of the diseases. Because the things that even you don't intend. Okay? What is your intention to be sick? No intention. Yalla, I'm ready now. Yalla, I want to be sick for one day. I want to be, yalla, I like to have headache for 3 hours. Okay, or there is a thorn. The Prophet said, حَتَّ الشَّوْكَ يُشَاكُهَا. The thorn. You sometimes like, you are sitting like this. This is a drawer. Okay. So, subhanAllah, a thorn. Brick you. Allah will forgive the sins. Or some of the sins. So, for the major sins, there should be tawbah. There should be tawbah. And what does it mean, tawbah? Or what are the conditions of tawbah? طيب, you mentioned many times. Shaykh Uthaymeen Rahimahullah mentioned 5 conditions for tawbah. Number 1, sincerity, ikhlas. Number 2, nidam, regret, feeling sorry. Number 3, to stop the sin. Number 4, to intend not to come again to the sin. Number 5, that repentance should be on time. These are the 5 conditions of tawbah. These are the 5 conditions of repentance. And the 6th one, if your sin relate to someone else, you have to make, to ask him the forgiveness. For example, if you stole something from someone, you have to return it back. I stole from many people, then I say, okay, I make tawbah. Your blood account is full of money from haram. Now you are declaring your tawbah, you should return the money to the people. You know that you stole this money from this man and this from this lady, from this. You have to return the money. So this is the 6th condition of repentance. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, آية نمبر 32، ولا تتمنوا ما فضل الله به بعضكم على بعض، للرجال نصيب مما اكتسبوا وللنساء نصيب مما اكتسبوا. And don't wish for that by which Allah has made some of you exceed others. For men is a share of what they have earned, and for women is a share of what they have earned. واسألوا الله من فضله إن الله كان بكل شيء عليما. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and ask Allah of his bounty. Indeed, Allah is ever of all things knowing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. SubhanAllah, this is the human nature. I noticed that this brother, that sister, they have something that I don't have. So it is nature that too. I wish to have the same or better. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't try to have this feeling toward the Muslim brother or sister. وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. The bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, you should accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the companions, some of the companions, poor, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is like a complaint. ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور يصلون كما نصلي ويصومون كما نصوم ويتصدقون بفضل أموالهم. Those who have wealth, those who are rich or wealthy, okay, they have more ajr than us. We pray, they pray. We fast, they fast. But where is the problem? Or yani, it is not a problem, but what is the difference? They have money, they can give charity, we don't have money. The Prophet ﷺ told them, okay, there are things like charity, tasbih, tahleel, amr ma'ruf, nahi munkar. There are several ways of charity. Because charity is not only to give money or to give food. Also tasbih, it is a kind of charity. Good word, charity. So now they are happy. But later they came to the Prophet ﷺ and they said, Ya Rasulullah, they hear the hadith. They hear the hadith, the rich people. And they are doing the same. Yani they are giving money as charity, and also they are saying tasbih and amma. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Darik fadlallahu yuti ma yasha." This is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He distributes his bounty according to his will. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so that's why he said subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, "Sallu Allah min fadli." Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means look at this person and that lady and this. Okay, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you what pleases you, to give you what makes you يعني to help people. And يعني there is a difference between hasad, okay, envy, which is haram, and al-ghibta, or something good. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the types of people. One of them, four types. One of them, okay, who has money, and he is using his money in the good things. You'll get the ajr. I have money and I build masjid. I have money and I feed people. I have money and I give needy people. This is very good. And the other type doesn't have money, but he's saying, Allah, mashallah, if I have money like this brother, I'll do the same. Haram, this is haram, hasad. Okay, this is, or we can say, this is good hasad. This is good hasad, good envy. This is good envy. If I, yani, if I have like them, I will do the same. This is haram? It's not haram. What is haram? What is the haram hasad? Two types of hasad. Okay, the haram hasad, okay, when you notice that he has money and you wish that he becomes poor. طيب تمني زوال النعمة من الغير. You wish, when you wish that this person to lose his money. تمني زوال النعمة من الغير. Not, of course, it is not only money. It can be knowledge. Maybe there is one brother, mashallah, he's حافظ قرآن. Okay, so he's like this. He's حافظ. No mistake. he is Imam Masjid for 10 years, no mistake at all. So you wish that he makes mistakes in the Salah, astaghfirullah al-Azim. Why? Okay, this bad heart, subhanAllah, evil heart. This is haram. Okay, but if you say, Wallah, I hope to have like his memory to lead the Salah like him. Jazakallah khair. Tamam. طيب. So you wish that he loses his يعني his quality or his money. And some scholars said, not only that, hasad. They give something more general about the definition of hasad, which is كراهية النعمة عند الغير. Okay? The first definition they say, you wish that he loses his money or his يعني quality. No, some scholars said something more general. To hate that he has a this virtue. I don't wish that he loses, but I feel he's half of the Quran. I feel, يعني for example, he came and he maybe people saying Mabruk. Why? He's half of the Quran. He finished Quran. He finished Quran with seven qiraat. طيب, he has PhD in Sharia. So you have like that feeling towards him. Okay, you hate this. طيب. So this is also a kind of hasad. Some scholars said, even this is hasad. This is envy and this is haram. You should wish good. You should feel happy toward the Muslim brothers and sisters when they have something good. Wallahi, a brother, he made Hafdul Quran full. Okay, you make dua for him, you'll be happy that he has Hafdul Quran. طيب. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِي بَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. Okay. This is like introduction. For what? لِلْرِجَالِ نَصِيبُ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا وَلِلنِّسَاءِ نَصِيبُ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا. And don't wish for that by which Allah has made some of you exceed others. For men is a share of what they have earned, and for women is a share of what they have earned. When we compare, the man has this. So you'll find that women feeling bad toward the men. And also the men, they look at women, they have this. So they feel also not happy toward what the women have. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, why? Why you are not happy? Okay. I gave everyone his things. Yani for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave for يعني, the man jihad, jum'ah, jama'ah, نفق على النساء, responsibility toward the women. يعني like these things. These are the responsibilities and also virtues for the man. Okay, no doubt jihad. Okay, it is responsibility. And also it is a virtue. When you fight in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jum'ah, you attend jum'ah. You attend the jama'ah. It is also responsibility and also like there is kind of tiredness. Okay, wallah, I leave the house and I go to the masjid. Okay, every time, yeah, for example, I walk to the masjid 10 minutes. And for the women, they are sitting at home and they are praying. Khalas. No need 10 minutes going, not 10 minutes coming. And today, maybe the imam is making the salah long or short. The woman is praying at home. Yalla. The first rak'ah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Second rak'ah, إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَا الْكَوْثَرَ. Finish. Khalas. So maybe some brothers telling the woman, the wife, yalla, you are lucky. You are praying at home. And maybe some sisters telling the man, you are lucky, you are praying in the masjid. Okay, no noise for the kids, and you are listening to the qira'ah. Okay, we should not have this feeling toward the others. Khalas, Allah gave everyone his, what suits him. Okay, and for the woman, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yani make for them hamil, or being pregnant, and breastfeeding the children to obey the husband. Okay. So everyone has what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for him. So don't look at the other one. So this is subhanAllah not from, should not be from Muslims. That the man has this and the woman has that. But there is a hadith that Salama, Rawah Tirmidhi, Al-Bani Mishl al-Sahih, she said, Ya Rasulullah, صلى الله عليه وسلم يغزو الرجال ولا نغزو من make غزو. What's mean غزو? Jihad, fighting, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we don't have غزو. ولنا نصف الميراث, and we take half. If you notice here, Umm Salama did not mention only the money. Before the money, she mentioned what? Jihad. Okay. So the women nowadays, they mention only the second part. They speak about money. Why we take only half? Okay. Be like Umm Salama. Umm Salama radiallahu anha. Also Umm Salama wondered radiallahu ta'ala anha. Okay. She asked, Ya Rasulullah, we take half. But before the inheritance, you mentioned what? Jihad. Why we are not making jihad? Are the women are talking like this today? Only they mention the second part, money. About the money. So if you like to ask, if you are wondering, be like Umm Salama, radiallahu ta'ala anha. Where is the question about the jihad? Okay. So before asking about the difference in wealth and in inheritance, ask, why you are not coming to the masjid jama'ah 5 times? Why it is not wajib? Any woman like this nowadays? Did you hear any woman who's saying why it is not compulsory to pray in the jama'ah? Okay. Only they are focusing what? The money, the inheritance. Okay. So Umm Salama radiallahu anha wondered, radiallahu anha, she said, Ya Rasulullah, jihad. Not only Umm Salama, also Aisha radiallahu anha. She asked about the jihad. Okay. And that you are men doing jihad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, also for you, there is a jihad. Lakunna, what kind of jihad? Hajj. Hajj also jihad for the mar'ah. This kind of jihad, subhanAllah. So she said, Ya Rasulullah, yaghzu al-rijal, wala naghzu, wala hunna, wala na nisfu al-mirath, half inheritance. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah. ولا تتمنوا ما فضل الله به بعضكم على بعض. الله سبحانه وتعالى revealed this ayah. So in this ayah, subhanAllah, there is psychological treatment. Because when people try to compare, خلاص, they will have anxiety, depression, being bad towards others. You like to compare? Compare. But how? With those who are less than. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, okay, if you want to compare, you to look at people who are less than you. Okay, you have a car. Okay, look at those who cannot walk. Okay, I have old car. Okay, every week I take my car to the garage. Look at people who cannot walk. My job, well, I am working every day 10 hours. Look, millions of people without job. I am paying rent. Millions of people homeless. SubhanAllah. If you think like that, you'll be satisfied. But if you are the opposite, you have a house, but you are looking at people who have palaces and one house in this country, the other house, the other country, you'll feel very bad and you will not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is this? My salary. What is this? My children, my wife, my job, my boss, my country. If you compare with those who are less than you, you will be happy. You will be satisfied. And this is a kind of treatment. Why people feel very bad? Okay? Because of this disease. To compare with those who are higher than them. And always when you look up, what will happen? You will get tired. So look down. Take a rest. Okay? Relax your muscle. The muscle of your neck. This is very important, but this is for dunya issues. But for the akhirah, no, you should look up. Okay? I memorize, for example, 2 juz. Look at those who are memorizing 4 juz. Okay, those who are coming at the time of iqama, I'm coming at the time of iqama. Look at people who are coming at the time of adhan. Okay, so in the akhirah, no, you should be. You look at those who are better than you. If it is related to the akhirah, it's very, very important. Also, يعني subhanAllah, we understand from the ayah that men and women are not the same. Men and women are not the same. But this doesn't mean that I am a man, I will enter paradise, and she is a woman, she will be in the hellfire. No. And also, it doesn't mean that every single man is better than every single woman. Okay? Fir'aun is a man. Is he better than Salama? No. And the Prophet mentioned that there are women are perfect. Perfect women. Okay? Like Fatima, Asiya, Maryam, Mujaman, and Khadija, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Perfect women. They are better than many men. For most of the men. Right? So, you know, when women read like these ayat or these hadith, immediately they feel bad. Why you feel bad? Work hard for the akhirah and you'll be better than many men. Don't focus on that, wallah, there is a man better than woman. Right? So you should be careful that our job, that to work hard to achieve the يعني, pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will not oppress you. Also, we learn from this ayah the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is al-Hakim. Allah is al-Hakim. Allah gives everyone what suits him. Be sure. This is very important. Why women don't come to the masjid? Why women that? Habibi, Allah knows better. Why? Because He created us. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. He knows. Why? Because He created us. So He knows better for us, better than us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Women, every month there is period. Okay, after delivery, she stays about 30, 40 days. Okay, the postpartum, bleeding. Women weaker than men, I mean as physically. So they don't come to the masjid. They stay at home to take care of the children. Khalas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everyone for what suits him. You should obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to trust what the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also we learn from this ayah that to achieve the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to work for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِلْرِجَالِ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا. That you did, or what they did. Do the things, okay? And Allah will not give the reward for the man because he is a man. Because I am a man, خلاص, Allah will give me the reward? No. You should make the righteous deeds. And also, what is very important here, that to heal the heart diseases, okay, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you feel something, bad toward this brother, that sister, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's very important, the dua. And one of the famous dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah marzuqni, الْهُدَى وَالتُّقَى وَالْعَفَافَ وَالْغِنَى. الْغِنَى, what's mean غِنَى? Satisfaction. Satisfaction, because if you are satisfied, you are rich. خلاص. Yeah, subhanAllah, sometimes you find cleaner. You know, how much is salary? Maybe 80 KD. And sometimes he gets his salary and sometimes no salary. You know the companies here in Kuwait, صح? How many times they don't give the salary? Haram, صح? But mashallah, you'll find him coming to the masjid, smiling, saying Alhamdulillah. صح? And many people, their salary, 10 times his salary. Or 20 times his salary. And always you'll find, what is this? Everything expensive, the government and the wife and the children complaining, all the time complaining. So the issue is not how much you have. The issue left with heart. So that's why you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مرزقنا الهدى والتقى والعفافة والغنى. غنى. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ليس الغنى عن كثرة العرض. ليس الغنى عن كثرة العرض ولكن الغنى غير النفس. Okay. Rich. What is the real richness? He said not how much money you have. ولكن الغنى غير النفس. The real richness that satisfaction. غنى النفس when your soul is rich. say Alhamdulillah. And also, we learn from this ayah. It is not haram to wish what the others have, but it is haram to have envy, hasad. Because, wallah, I like to have what, like what he has, no problem. But the problem, when you wish, you ask Allah or you wish that he loses his money, this is haram. But to wish, wallah, I like to have like his house, alhamdulillah, okay? It is not haram. I like to have like this car, this mobile, this shirt, no problem. But the problem when there is a bad, ill feeling towards him. Okay, inshallah, jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.